What's up everyone, my name is Alex Costa, welcome back to my channel. If you're looking to enhance your appearance and take your style to the next level, then you've come to the right place. It's 2021, things are starting to open up again. Everyone is trying to upgrade their style, bring out the best in themselves, and I don't want you to be left out. So if that sounds good to you, then hit that subscribe button and join the YouTube family. I want you to look and feel your best so that when you step into a room, you're automatically the best looking person in that room and everyone suddenly wishes they could look as good as you do. By the end of this video, I'm gonna show you how to get everything right, from your hair to your skin to your style. The first thing you need to do to improve your appearance immediately is shape your facial hair properly. Guys, we don't live in the ice ages, we're not cavemen. Pay attention to your facial hair. Whether you wanna grow out your facial hair, go clean shaven, just make sure it doesn't look rough and dirty. Those in-between styles don't really work. Either shave it or grow it and trim it and keep it nice and tidy. So the best thing that you can do is understand your individual and unique facial hair needs. Another great way to improve your appearance immediately, right, like this, is obviously lower your body fat. We have to be honest with ourselves. If you look at a guy and he's fit, he looks healthy, then that's probably gonna look better than if a guy does not look healthy and he is unfit. So if you want to improve your appearance, you have to cut down fat, your body fat, and get into shape. This is of course only for the guys that need to do that, right? And if you do need to do that, you understand, you probably already know. So go on a diet, hit the gym, start jogging, running, exercising, anything to get you active to cut down that body fat. You're gonna find out that the more you exercise to cut down body fat, the better you begin to feel about yourself. Like I always tell you guys, when you're confident, you're attractive, and exercising does make you feel more confident. And don't just cut body fat because you wanna have abs and improve your appearance and look cool. Do it because you want to feel better about yourself. Do it because you want to be healthier. Improving your overall appearance begins with improving yourself from within. Now, one of the main things that you guys are always concerned about and always asking me about this is skincare. Guys, you know that having clear skin is going to greatly improve your appearance and make you super attractive. That is why you need to develop a really good skincare routine. And by that, I mean, you need to be consistent. You have to always be on top of it because it's better to do it and prevent it than to try to fix it later. Today's video is sponsored by Geology, and let me tell you, they make incredible products that are unique to your needs, and that's how they stand out. The Geology Essential line is specially formulated to get rid of acne, pimples, blackheads, right? All of that breakout. You don't want that. We want clear skin. We want smooth skin. It's actually divided into a very simple two-step regimen, which means it's very easy to use. And the first step is a face wash. All you need to do is put about 3 to 4 pumps of the Geology Everyday Face Wash into your hands and then gently apply it to your face or neck. This is a really gentle, easy to use face wash, and it's famous for its deep cleaning, oil reducing, and acne inhibiting properties. And just a reminder, guys, when you're doing your skincare routine, do not forget about your neck. Most guys will wash their faces, moisturize it, and then that's it. But you gotta remember your neck too. Otherwise, you're gonna have lines here, you're gonna get ingrown hairs, and the face wash is definitely going to help. So gently apply it to your face and then your neck as well in the mornings and in the evenings, twice a day. It's so easy, it smells nice, it's going to feel really nice. Your face is gonna be free of all dirt and germs that could cause you any problems in the future. Of course, acne being one of those problems. Now, I'm not saying you have to wash your face a bunch of times a day. I'm saying twice a day. Do not overwash. Washing your face too many times can actually cause your skin to produce even more oil and make your skincare regimen less effective. Instead, just use warm water to gently refresh your face if you have to throughout the day. The second step is treating your face at night, an hour or two before you go to bed. All you need to do is dab 3 to 4 pumps of the repairing night cream onto your forehead, your cheeks, and your neck, and let it work its magic. A little goes a long way with this here, so just rub it in with your fingertips in circular motions, make sure it gets into every part of your face evenly, and avoid your eyes. You do not want it around your eyes because the repairing night cream actually contains some really effective ingredients, one of them being retinol. And retinol is gonna help your skin get rid of acne by clearing out your pores, helping your skin produce new, fresh cells to give you nice, clear skin that we all deserve, that we all want. So guys, start taking care of your skin right now. Don't wait. Click the link in the description below and make sure to check out the Geology website to get your own personalized product. All you do is take their free skincare quiz to get a plan customized to you and your personal needs. And you can get a plan as low as 20 bucks. And you actually get to save 40% off on your first purchase if you click the link below. So I'll leave the link in the description below and you guys can go and check out Geology. Something that I've been talking about a lot here on the channel that really improves your appearance is getting enough sleep. You would agree with me that the way you look in the morning is determined by how well you slept the night before, right? When you get very little sleep, when you don't sleep well, you wake up and you literally look super groggy and like disgruntled and your eyes are baggy, and it's going to affect your appearance for the rest of the day. When you don't get enough sleep, no matter how well you dress, no matter how good your hair looks, no matter how much skincare you do, you're not gonna look your best, and that is just the truth. So guys, let's love ourselves here. Let's get in the habit of not staying up all night, binge watching a series or playing video games. Make sure that you go to bed early enough so that you can wake up early and feel recharged, feel good, and of course, look good without any bags under your eyes and no dark circles. And if you're gonna go to bed late, which I know some of you do, I know, it's normal, it happens, at least try to sleep for like 7 to 8 hours, right? Don't go to bed late when you have to wake up early, because that's just not going to look good on you. The next tip for improving your appearance, of course, is the clothing that you wear. One of the most important aspects about your appearance is gonna be your style. And you just have to get it right. There's no escaping that, right? If you guys have been watching my channel for a while, then you already know a lot of the style tips that I give you guys here. I see some guys that show up to an event or an occasion in like really oversized clothing or like really tight clothing, and I just can't get around that. You have to make sure that your clothes that you're wearing fit you properly, and you have to understand how they fit you. When you wear clothes that are really baggy, for example, and you want to do that because it's on trend and you mean to do that, that's fine, it looks good. When you wear, you know, slim fit jeans or skinny jeans and you mean to do that, that is your style, that is okay. The problem is when you're wearing really baggy t-shirts and skinny jeans, or really baggy pants and a really tight shirt, it just does not look good. You have to understand your sizing and really dress by it. It's okay if you want to feel loose and comfortable and go for baggy clothing. I know that you guys have seen my lookbooks in the past and I've worn some baggy clothing and it looks cool, as long as you know that. Other than that, if you're not looking to go with the trend and get the baggy clothing, then make sure that your outfit is tailored perfectly to your size to give you a nice, clean, sharp look. There is nothing better than a tailored look that fits you like a glove. And since we're talking about clothing, guys, you have to know how to mix and match your colors. One thing that ruins a great outfit is not balancing your colors, right? As much as you pay attention to how well your clothes fit, and maybe they're super nicely tailored and they fit you like a glove, make sure they're the right color. Choose colors that complement each other and that complement your skin tone. Everyone's skin tone is different, which means the colors are gonna look different on me than they do on you. Sometimes wearing only black and white, everything can be boring, right? So it's okay to spice out your outfit, maybe with a bit of color on the sneakers or a hat, something that brings out the color. On a suit, for example, a pocket square can bring out a lot of color. The tie can bring out a lot of color, even if you're wearing a black suit. But my personal advice on this one here is just don't put too many bright colors together, because otherwise you're just gonna look like the rainbow, like an ice cream truck. It's just not the vibe, right? You have to understand that too many colors will kind of break that harmony. So if you're wearing something like this, which is super basic, gray and white, and you throw on some shoes that have a different color, like navy shoes or navy pants, that is okay. If I'm gonna wear red sneakers with this, it's just too much. And I know I mentioned skin tone, but something else that also really helps you define what kind of colors look good on you is your eye color, right? Depending on the eye color that you have, for example, I have green eyes, and when I wear green shirts, my eyes look even greener. It looks good on me. If you're wearing silver jewelry, take that into account, versus if you're wearing gold jewelry, then maybe a yellow could look pretty good to bring it all together. Now, I know it's getting warm outside. We're going into summer, especially here if you live in the US. Right, but a great way to spice up your outfit is by wearing a jacket. It doesn't have to be a jacket that's gonna keep you warm. It could be a nice windbreaker, something really, really thin. You know that I love my jackets. I just think it adds a flair to your outfit. It adds some layers, some thickness to your frame, right? You can look a little bit bigger, more muscular. That extra buff or that extra weight on your clothing, it helps you appear more attractive. It really does. And it shows people that you have more layering, that you have more style. It gives you an extra layer of style. Think of it that way. If you were just wearing a t-shirt and jeans, it can look really good, especially if you're super fit. But if you add a jacket, it's just something else that people can comment on. It's a conversation starter. Plus, if you're going on a date and it gets chilly and the girl needs a jacket, I'm just saying, be a gentleman, you know, take yours off, give it to her. It works out. What can I say, man? I'm a little old school when it comes to that stuff. Something that I wanted to talk to you guys about, I don't think I've talked about this much here on the channel, but I think it's really important, is your mannerism, right? And how people take that and try to figure out whether or not you're confident. What I wanted to kind of dive into today is fidgeting, or acting too quickly, moving around too much. Appearance isn't only about what you wear, what you smell like, even though it does help. It's about how you carry yourself. So we've talked a lot about posture, right? But fidgeting makes you look uncomfortable, makes you look anxious, and it can actually make you look anxious without you even knowing, because you don't even know that you're fidgeting. That's why some people start sweating even in the most relaxed environment. If you want to appear as confident as possible, you have to try to avoid fidgeting. Instead, you're gonna use slow, deliberate movements so that you don't get anxious or look anxious for no reason. Guys, I don't mean that you should start acting in slow motion, right? You're not doing this. I'm just saying you shouldn't rush any movements. You shouldn't be picking your nose. You shouldn't be putting your hands in your pockets and taking them out. You shouldn't be, you know, picking your nails. Take your time with whatever you're doing. Understand your hand movements so that you don't come out as clumsy and, you know, mess up a possible date or opportunity. I know that during interviews, you're probably gonna be a little bit more nervous and anxious. You know, keep your hands in your pocket. Keep your hands on the desk. If you're doing a presentation at school, grab, you know, the desk and that's it. Don't move too much unless you're using hand gestures to show what you mean and put emphasis into what you're saying, like I do here with my video. This next tip, one of my favorites on the list, how you smell, right? And I cannot emphasize this enough. You have to pay attention to how you smell. People are definitely going to judge you by how you smell. And now, it can go really well and you can have a great cologne. It can go eh if you have a bad cologne, but at least you don't smell bad. Or it can go really bad if you forgot to put deodorant on, if you didn't take a shower. Then we're talking about basic hygiene here, guys. Truth is, it's not just about basic hygiene. If you walk into a room smelling like every other guy, like every basic person out there, then you're just gonna blend in. But when you step in, smelling like a million bucks, now that's what I'm talking about. I have so many videos on different colognes here on the channel, but if you'd like me to make more, I was actually thinking about making one about the five colognes that every guy needs, the five colognes that every guy needs to buy first before anything else. Let me know if you guys wanna see that, and I will surely shoot that video for you guys. And when I say that, by the way, please do not just go like 12 sprays, right? Like 4 to 6 sprays is perfect. There is no reason that you would need more than that. Now, one thing that I personally just can't live without, that I absolutely love and that I think makes every guy look better, is a watch. As a guy, most of our noticeable features, you know, it's gonna be the jewelry that we wear. And a lot of guys don't even wear rings, and I understand that, but a watch, this here, I feel like every guy should. If you want to improve your appearance, then it's all in the details, and the watch will go a long way. And look, there's no need to get an expensive luxury watch. You can start small, start with fashion watches, and then work your way up if it's something that you like. Like, I absolutely love watches. I have a collection. I really, really do. But I understand that that's not everyone's vibe. Get a watch that makes your outfits come together. And not only does it make you look more mature and stylish, it tells the world that you're confident, that you're on time. It just shows people that you're not a little kid. You know what I'm saying? Like, yes, I can tell the time on my phone, but the watch just brings my outfit together. Huge shout out to Geology for sponsoring today's video. Guys, if you want clear skin, if you want an easy product, and if you want a product that is designed for you, then you have to check out Geology. That's how they stand out. They literally will make their formulation based on your needs, and that is extremely cool. I think that's very important nowadays. So go check them out. The link is in the description below. Thank you guys so much for watching today's video, and I'll see you again very, very soon. Peace.